Arde! 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 Hello guys from Maestro Itio Copelli, welcome back to my channel. This video is going to be in English and in Italian because my friends are from English, are from all over the world and from Italy, but some of my friends in Italy they don't speak English, quindi parlerò anche in italiano in questo video. Today I'm gonna make a fest. I'm going to make the focaccia barese. I'm going to make 120% of hydration. Yes, 120% hydration. Oggi ragazzi vi dimostrerò come fare la focaccia al 120% di idratazione. Che l'abbiamo messa. In this video, of course, you see behind me the classic Madia. This is a box that I'm going to put for sale very soon. Link in description. Very soon, coming soon. Stay posted in my social media. Go on Instagram now, Vito Iacopelli, and follow me there too. Because this is gonna be available soon. Actually, also with my online of product, flour and tomato. Besides this, we're gonna get into this video and making the focaccia. I have a friend of mine that is gonna help me directly from Bari. Vieni, sta facendo il video. Ci abbiamo qui Andrea.
Ciao ragazzi.
Mi aiuterà a fare la focaccia al 120% perché lui è chef, vuole superare sempre i suoi limiti. Abbiamo fatto una focaccia in passato al 110% e lui mi ha detto: perché non facciamo il 120%? E io ho detto: of course, facciamo al 120% e dobbiamo fare il video. Guys, I was saying, this is Chef Andre, comes from Bari, and he, last time he's a very challenging guy, and then he made a focaccia 110%, together we made it, and I say, why we don't make it 120%? So today, in this video, we're gonna make a 120% hydration focaccia, 120% l'idratazione del focaccia da resa.
Andiamo.
Andiamo a farla?
Certo.
Vai, questo è quello che ci serve.
500 grams of flour. 600 grams of water. 4 grams of dry yeast. 15 grams of extra virgin olive oil. 10 grams of honey. And 19 grams of sea salt.
Ok, now that we see the ingredients, amici, ora che abbiamo visto gli ingredienti, I'm gonna ask a couple of questions for my friend here, Andrea. He doesn't speak good English, so I'm gonna speak in Italian for my friend, of course. Andrea, perché stiamo dando un 120% di idratazione in questa focaccia? Perché?
Perché dando il 120% in pratica risulta all'interno molto soft, molto morbida, tipo marshmallow, e sopra e sotto risulta abbastanza croccante, perché ne andiamo a mettere anche l'olio. Poi ovviamente è anche molto leggera come impasto, è abbastanza leggero.
Fantastico, ma traduco un attimo.
Certo,
in
certo.
Guys, so we are going to give 100, according to the chef Andrea here, actually we are going to give 120%. Why? Because 120% gives a lot of air and softness to the crust, so the water will evaporate in the oven and will give a lot of bubbles inside that will be really light. Try this at home, please, and when you make it, please tag me on Instagram. Amici, quando fate questa focaccia, taggateci su Instagram. Grazie e andiamo a vedere come fare l'impasto al momento. Let's go see how to make the dough.
First thing to do, we add the yeast with the water in a bowl. Mix it up, we melt really good the yeast in the water. Now let's add the honey. Let's mix it up again. Now it's time to add our flour. Just follow the video. You have to add the flour little by little. Make sure you have someone that helps you. Just like that. Okay, now that we add all flour, we start to mix it up just like that. Gently, when all the flour is nice and integrated with the water, we have to start to mix it up really, really hard and fast, like you can see now. Once the flour is nice integrated, now we start to put the olive oil little by little. We are not done yet to mix it up, which this is just the beginning. Now you see, I'm gonna start to sweat a little bit, but that's okay, that's part of this recipe. There we go. Now we're gonna start the hard work. Are you ready? If you're a woman, don't worry, call your husband. He deserves to do the hard work. Don't worry. Okay, now almost at the end, we have to add the salt. Don't forget, little by little. There we go. Now we mix it. We integrate the salt in the hard dough. And again, call back your husband. We're gonna mix. We're gonna mix it really, really hard this time until the dough is nice and mix up really, really well.
Vai, vai, scott, lo scott è proprio 120, compa, vai, 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 a me.
Guys, really hard, really hard. Otherwise, it's not gonna come out good. If you're a woman, call your husband now and ask him to make the dough, make the dough! Hard, hard, hard! Wow. Now we leave it at room temperature for about 2-3 hours. Then after this, we put it in the fridge for 16 hours.
Here how we find the dough after 2 hours at that room temperature. Ecco come troviamo la focaccia dopo 2 ore a temperatura ambiente. Now, at this point, we can put it in the fridge for 16 hours. Ora la mettiamo in frigo per 16 ore. Here you go, guys. 16 hours been passed by, and this is how we find the dough. You see, it's gonna get sit, but don't worry about. Ecco qui, dopo 16 ore, amici miei, come troverete la focaccia. Si è seduto un po', però non vi allarmate, perché è ancora molto buona e piena di aria. Here you go, guys. So now it's time to put it in a pan.
So now we need a pan like this one, not exactly like this one, because this comes from my hometown body. And the first thing to do is we're gonna put some olive oil, extra virgin olive oil. So now we leave it outside the room temperature for 1 hour outside the room temperature. Of course, now we're gonna close it with a plastic wrap. We let it rest at room temperature for about 1 hour. Welcome, buongiorno. I just woke up, like you can see my hair. I just take it out. This morning I came here with my eyes like this, just wake up. I take out the dough from the fridge, like you can see, and I put it on the pan. Then I got a coffee like this, and now I can start to do the face-to-face. This is the focaccia after 2 hours. My friend Andrea, unfortunately, is still sleeping. I'm gonna call him, but he's gonna come soon. Soon he's gonna come. This is the dough. After 2 hours, voila! Wow! Take off the. At this point, we are ready to put our olives. To make our focaccia, we need to put the olives, cherry tomato, oregano, and salt. So let's put the olives. Be careful, because this one, we just gotta dump the olive, just like that. No press, nothing. Cherry tomato. And we give it a cut, just like that, in between. We cut it. Now we add the tomato, just like that. Now, we put the oregano, fresh. Just like that. Just like that. Wow. Just like that, we give a flavor. It's amazing. Amazing, it reminds me. Every time I make the focaccia, it reminds me of my hometown, Bari. Wow, I miss it so much. It's okay, it's okay. I'll go this summer. Voila, done. A little bit of sea salt. If you have the thick one, go with the thick one. Voila, put it all the way. Oh, focaccia, bam, 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 voila. Woo! And now we're gonna put a little bit of fresh olive oil, like this, from Puglia. Wow! That's it. That's it. Now we get our focaccia just like that. Don't touch it anymore. We let it rest for another 30 minutes at room temperature, just like that. Done.
Very important to preheat the oven at 365. Preimpostate e riscaldate il forno alla temperatura di 190 gradi.
Ok, so we preset the oven at 180, like you can see here is about 360. So make sure you preheat the oven before you put the focaccia. So now that it's preheat, we can go ahead and put the focaccia in the oven. Done. We close it and we preset the time at 35 minutes. And we have a couple of seconds and the focaccia is finally ready. There we go, see? Fantastic. Woo! Off the... Amazing. Wow, be careful, don't get burned. Wow, let's go see better.
Action.
Wow, the focaccia is finally ready. You don't even imagine the smell of this focaccia. Really reminds me of my grandmother when she was making all the focaccias. Every morning, 50 focaccias, guys. That's amazing. I'm gonna leave a picture right here. Check it out. And finally, let's get back to the focaccia. It's ready. I'm gonna take it out. I place it right here just to see. Wow, done. 120% of hydration. I'm gonna cut it right here. We're gonna check it out the center. This nice and crunchy. Wow, nice and crunchy. And this is the moment of the truth. Done. Wow, guys, we made a really thin crust focaccia, because that's how they make it in Bari, but you know, it's always a different places, how they make, sometimes they make a thicket, sometimes they make a thin, sometimes they put the tomatoes, but this is the side. But today, I wanna taste it with you guys. It's amazing, look at this. It's the time for tasting. I close my eyes because I wanna feel that I'm in Italy, in my own town. Amazing. Amazing, 120%, we did it. This deserves a thumbs up. We're gonna call our friends Andrea, that finally he wake up. Andrea, vieni qua, vieni, vieni ad assaggiare la focaccia, vieni. Mamma mia, no. Vieni! Andrea, vieni! Vieni! Oh, finalmente, no. Che cosa è?
Uè, ma, è pronta?
Hai portato anche a... L'hai svegliato mia madre? Andrea, vieni, vieni più al centro, vieni.
Andiamo, andiamo.
L'hai svegliato, stava dormendo stamattina. Cioè, gli dico di facciamo un video.
Mi sono addormentato.
Può bene fare, a lui me la focaccia, madre. So.
Wow, che focaccia.
This is 120% hydration. 120.
Sembra di stare a Bari, eh?
Vabbè, tu sei di Bari, pure quello contaccio, vai.
Vai, vai, Maria.
Io un altro pezzo me lo faccio.
Wow,
non è che era una piece.
Voilà.
Because this focaccia is so light.
Cin cin.
Cin cin. Cin.
Delicious.
Mm. It come out so light, guys. I mean, try this at home, please. And thumbs up. See you soon.
Provatela.